Welcome to my little video, which will show you how I would like you to paint your Bondaweb. Controlling me? The reason why we paint Bondaweb is that you get these beautiful effects if you don't add too much paint to the Bondaweb. That's why I've made this little video for you, just to give you a good idea. So these are the kind of effects that you can achieve. You can mix the colours if you mix your paint sparingly. So here is what you will need. Need a jug of water, a paintbrush, some dressmaking pins, a pair of scissors, some paint. Acrylic paint's fine if you water it down by about half, and some newspaper to pin your Bondaweb onto. So Bondaweb is a very thin layer of glue, and the great thing about the backing paper is it ripples when you make it wet. So I would recommend, these are just my recommendations, cut your Bondaweb to the size of the newspaper. You don't want bits hanging over the edge because it's very irritating. Pin the corners of the Bondaweb to the newspaper. It's handy having it attached to the newspaper because then you can just move the whole thing around, lay it somewhere safe to dry where you're not going to get paint. Have a pile of newspapers to hand maybe, to spread out on the floor. Depending on how wet you make your Bondaweb and how dry the room is, it can take up to a day, maybe even 24 hours for your Bondaweb to dry properly, and you do need to use it dry. Once you've pinned your Bondaweb onto the newspaper and you're making sure that the rough side is up, you can then add water very sparingly to the surface of the Bondaweb. I'm using a little bit of paint in the water so you can see what happens when it starts to ripple. You don't want great puddles of water. And you need to use the paint sparingly. I tend to use it straight from the pot. If you're not quite sure how thick everything should be, you can water down your paint and pop it into a pallet and then use it from there. As you can see here, one side of the Bondaweb is darker than the other. I've used more paint on one side. Do merge your colours together, particularly for my workshops, because we're looking at backgrounds. We don't want anything too striking and too contrasting. Nothing stripy. So as you can see, that's all mixed in quite well. And then you can create all kinds of beautiful colours. By mixing your paints or just using them straight from the pot, whatever you fancy, and you will get lovely rippled surfaces once it's dry. So have fun.